He lay still a long time after that, until the moonlight crept around the boat and drove away the shadow. Then he got up and went slowly down to the water's edge with Joan's rose, all wet with his unaccustomed tears, in his hands. Slowly and reverently, he plucked off the petals and scattered them on the ripples, where they drifted lightly off like fairy shallops on moonshine. When the last one had fluttered from his fingers, he went back to the house and hunted up Captain Alec Matheson, who was smoking his pipe in the corner of the veranda and watching the young folks dancing through the open door. The two men talked together for some time. When the dance broke up and the guests straggled homeward, Paul sought Joan. Rob Shelley had his own girl to see home and relinquished the guardianship of his sister with a scowl. Paul strode out of the kitchen and down the steps at the side of Joan. Smiling with his usual daredevilry, he whistled noisily all the way up the lane. "Great little dance," he said. "My last in prospect for a spell, I guess." "Why?" asked Joan wonderingly. "Oh, I'm going to take a run down to South America in Matheson's schooner. Lord knows when I'll come back. This old place has got too deadly dull to suit me. I'm going to look for something livelier." She trembled violently and put one of her small brown hands up to her throat. You're not coming back?" she said faintly. "Not likely. I'm pretty well tired of Prospect, and I haven't got anything to hold me here. Things will be livelier down south." Joan said nothing more. They walked along the spruce-fringed roads where the moonbeams laughed through the thick, softly swaying boughs. Paul whistled one rollicking tune after another. The girl bit her lips and clenched her hands. He cared nothing for her. He had been making a mock of her as of others. Hurt pride and wounded love fought each other in her soul. Pride conquered.